How the cell functionally and structurally oriented. And cell to tissues, tissues to organs, organs to systems, systems. How they are formed, how they are formed. So for these all questions, the answer is growth and development. It means the growth is started with very single cell, that is diploid cell, that is zygote. Zygote is go for successive cell divisions, then the cells are multiplies, then turn as a tissues. Tissues. These tissues are organized for a specific function and also they are made as organs. The organs can regulate the system. So many systems are included in living organisms. When you come to the plant wise, the development is in two stages. The development is two stages. One is growth. Another one is differentiation. 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 For this development, many factors are influenced. The factors are influenced for development. They are intrinsic factors and extrinsic factors. But first of all, what is growth? Growth. So growth is nothing but of, it is a process. It is the common feature of all living organisms. The growth is regarded as a fundamental characteristic feature of living organisms. And it is irreversible, permanent increase in size of an organism. Sometimes the part also, the part of the plant also increased. Even individual cell also increased. That phenomena is called growth. But it is permanent. It do not reversible. Irreversible, permanent increase of cell or tissue or part of the body or organism. That is called growth. Growth. Is growth? Can we determine the growth? Yes, we determine the growth. The growth is shown by some tissues. The tissues are meristematic tissues. When the meristematic tissues present in the plant body, they go for multiplication, rapid multiplication. They go for production of tissues and further development of plant body. Here, the growth is two types, primary growth and secondary growth. Primary growth and secondary growth. At the primary growth, the cells are formed, the tissues are formed, the cells are matured, stem, root, leaves are produced. But when you see in internal structure or anatomical, vascular cambium, cork cambium, intrafascicular cambium, these are activated to produce the many cells. The phase is called secondary growth. At the primary growth, they contribute the elongation of the plant. Elongation of plant through main axis. But in secondary growth, the plant width-wise it increases. also show impact on the growth of the plant. Generally, the plant growth at primary level conducted by meristematic tissue. The meristematic tissue present at root apex and shoot apex. The terminal portions of root as well as shoot. There, the rapid growth conducted by meristematic tissue that resulted to primary growth. The primary growth represented as elongation of the plant. And come to the secondary growth, when width-wise it increasing, here the cambium, the inactivated cambium becomes activated. Vascular cambium, cork cambium, intravascular cambium, these all become active to promote the growth. So that is called secondary growth. Is growth measurable? Yes, the growth is measurable. But in, you see in cell, when the cell is increasing, when cell is enlarged, it means the cell is increasing number wise as well as size wise. When it is increasing number wise, the number of cells are formed. But when it increases size wise, the cell enlargement is happened. How it is happened? Because of improvement or enhancement of the protoplast. The protoplast is increased and it shows some pressure, culture pressure onto the cell walls. Then the cell wall become increased. That leads to cell enlargement. So the protoplast increase, we do not determine, we do not measure, we do not, it is not measurable. But when you see morphological or morphological feature of the plant, according to that we can measure. For example, you see the size of the plant. The size of the plant is increased from millimeters to centimeter. The number of leaves are increased from 10 approximately 10 numbers to 20 numbers. Like we can measure.